Hi everyone, we started here geometry. So in this geometry, first basic geometrical ideas. So what are the terms present in geometry, we'll learn here. Till now, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. Here, basic geometrical ideas. In this, first one is point. If we keep a dot on a paper or on a board, that we call as a point. Line segment. Line segment means if the length between any two points, that line, that is called as line segment. It has two ends. It ends here and it ends here. Two ends. That is line segment. AB line segment. It shows as AB like this. AB line segment. Ray. If a line segment has one side it has end and another side it is endless. If it is continuous, then this we call as a ray. Ray is denoted by AB like this. If arrow is this side, then we should denote it as BA ray, not AB. BA. This is AB, B side it is prolonging, BA, it is A side it is prolonging. Like this we have to show. Next, line. If line segment, both the sides, if it endless, AB, both sides if it continuous, prolongs, B side and prolongs A side, then we call this as a line. Line shows by, with line symbol on that AB. This is line. If you have a point, this is a question here. If you have a point, how many lines can be drawn through this point? So, through this point, I can draw a line through this point. I can draw second line through this point. Sorry, I can draw third line. So, fourth line, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. So, infinite lines, we can draw through a point, we can draw infinite lines. This is very important. Through a point, one point, how many lines we can draw? Infinite lines we can draw through a point. If you have two points, how many lines can you draw through two points? Only one point, sorry, one line. So, this is the line. Through two points. So, this line should pass through two points. That's why we can draw only one line. So, through one point we can draw infinite lines, but through two points we can draw only one line. If any closed figure with line segments like this, A, B, C, D, E. So, AB line segment, AE line segment, DE, DC, CB, AB, all these are line segments. If we have a closed figure with finite, not infinite, finite line segments, then we call this as a polygon. We call this as a polygon. And this polygon, and not only this, we can, this also a polygon, and this is also a polygon. So it should has some line segments. Closed figure. So these are all called as polygons. In these polygons, so the part inside of this polygon is called interior. Outside of this polygon is called as exterior. And this line segments, that is called boundary. Boundary of this polygon. This is A, B, C, D, E, A. This is line. These lines are, line is boundary of that polygon. And boundary and this interior. Boundary and this interior means this total combinedly called as region of this polygon. Region of this polygon. Interior and boundary combinedly called as its a region. Here this is in mass. This line also we call as simple curve. line, straight line also we call it as a simple curve. So here this figure made with simple curves, and this also made with simple curves. But if you take this figure, this is not with simple curves. So sorry, curve, not cure, curve, simple curves. So you may get question, which of the following are with simple curves? Means this is also a curve, simple curve, not curve, simple curve. This is with simple curve and this is also with simple curve. This type of figures, we cannot say these as simple curves. So we have angle. Angle means if this is a ray, O-A-ray. From here, if it rotates like this, at this point OB, it rotates to OA to OB. Then these two OA and OB are called as arms of this figure, and the point from where it started, so this is end point of this ray, that is called as vertex, and this is the angle which is formed between OA and OB arms, this is called angle. Okay, here if you take, now only I told about polygon. If this is also a polygon, so with three sides, that polygon with three sides is called as triangle, closed figure, triangle. If you take any four sides, polygon with four sides, that is called as quadrilateral. So these quadrilaterals, we have different types. Triangles also, we have different types. We'll see in this chapter only. So quadrilaterals. Quadrilaterals also, squares, rectangles, okay, trapeziums, all comes under quadrilaterals with four sides. These are called sides with four sides, that is called quadrilateral. Scientist Euclid, Greek scientist Euclid, he gave geometry in logical order. So in his book The Elements, his book written by Euclid, The Elements, so this is very important question, The Elements book written by Euclid on geometry in logical order, and his geometry is called as Euclidean geometry. If you go for angles, this is one angle 30 degrees and this is 60 degrees. If sum of any two angles is equal to 90 degrees, 30 plus 60 is 90. If sum of two angles is 90 degrees, then we can say these two angles as complementary angles. This pair of angles called as complementary angles. Next, if you take, this is 120, this is 60. Sum of these two angles equal to 180 degrees. When sum of two angles 180 degrees, then these two angles pair called as supplementary angles. This is complementary, this is supplementary. In this figure, you can observe these two angles are adjacent. Pakka pakkanne unnai. So these two angles are called as adjacent angles. If you look here, this is a line and this is a line. Here we can get two angles, but these are adjacent angles, and you can observe this is a straight line. By doing sum of these two, x and y, we will get 180 degrees. Why? Because this is a straight line. So angle on a straight line is always equal to 180 degrees. So pair of adjacent angles. So if you have taken different angles, if their sum is 180, then those are supplementary. But if the angles are adjacent and their pair sum is equal to 180 degrees, then we can say those as linear pair of angles. Next, in this figure, if these two lines are intersecting at this point, so at the point of intersection, the angles formed opposite to one another are called as vertically opposite angles. These vertically opposite angles are always equal. X is equal to Y. We go for angles. So if angle is 0 degrees, that is called zero angle. Means here we have OA ray. It is not moved from here. It is on this only. It is not moved. It is not rotated. That's why we call here we have angle zero angle. If it moved for 90 degrees, then this is called right angle. Exact 90 degrees. This is called right angle. If it moved here to here, total 180 degrees, then we call this as straight angle. If the angle between 0 and 90. More than 0, less than 90. So means 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 89. This angle is called as acute angle. Less than 90, more than 0. And the angle between 90 and 180, obtuse angle, more than 90 and less than 180. Next, angle between 180 and 360, up to here 180 degrees. Next, more than 180, up to 360, means here total. That is called reflex angle, means after 180 completion, then we call it as reflex angle. And if ray moved from here to here, total again it takes comes to same place. OA, OB on same, here also same, but it is not moved from here, then zero angle. If it moved from here and again reached the same place, then this total angle, this is called total angle. This total angle is always equal to 360 degrees. Total angle is always equal to, exactly equal to 360 degrees. Here we have different types of lines. If these two lines cannot intersect at any point, if these two lines has no common point, then these are called parallel lines. The distance between these two parallel lines at any place, the distance between these two parallel, these two lines are always equal. Those are only called as parallel lines. Next, if two lines has only one common point, two lines have only one common point, these are called intersecting lines. If two intersecting lines, if they have 90 degrees angle, if they are separated with 90 degrees angle, means with right angle, those are called perpendicular lines. If any line intersects two distinct lines at two distinct points, then that is called transversal. If a line intersects two or more than two lines at distinct points, then that is called a transversal. This transversal, by intersecting two lines, it makes like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It can make totally 8 angles. In these angles, corresponding angles means angle 1 should be, here we have 4, 3, 6, 5 are called as interior angles. These are interior, inside of the lines. So interior angles. Angle 1, 2, 7, 8 are called as exterior angles. So here we have 4 exterior angles are for interior angles. So one exterior and one interior, and both are same side of the transversal. 1 and 5. Same side of the transversal, and one is exterior and one is interior. This type of pair of angles is called as corresponding angles. So here, and 1 and 5 corresponding angles, 4 interior, 8 exterior, and same side of the transversal. So 4 and 8, a pair of corresponding angles. 2 and 6 and 3 and 7, these are the corresponding angle pairs. If you take parallel lines, so these two are A, B one line and C, D another line. If these two are parallel lines, if we have a transversal, the transversal also makes 8 angles with these two parallel lines. Then corresponding angles means one is exterior and one is interior, and both should on the same side of the transversal. Those are called corresponding angles. So if transversal intersects two parallel lines, then these corresponding angles are equal. So angle 1 is when these two are parallel only. This is condition. So angle 1 is equal to angle 5, or angle 4 is equal to angle 8, or angle 2 is equal to angle 6, or angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Next, alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles means these interior angles, both should be interior angles and alternate to the transversal, means opposite side of the transversal. Those two are called as alternate interior angles. If two interior angles opposite to the transversal. Those two are called alternate interior angles. So angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Alternate interior angles are also equal. Angle 3 is equal to angle 5. And angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Next, vertically opposite angles. Here you can observe angle 1 and 3. 1, 3. Vertically opposite angles equal. 2, 4. Vertically opposite angles. 5, 7. And 8, 6. So, these vertically opposite angles are equal. And interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Alternate means opposite side of the transversal. Now we are coming for interior angles means 4 and 5 on the same side of the transversal. 4, 5. So 4 and 5, those are sum of these two interior angles is 180. Means pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. Means their sum is 180 degrees. So angle 4 plus 5 is 180. Angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180. Here we have one example. Here in this, from this figure, triangle ABC is a triangle and L is a line. L, this is a line L, and here this is the symbol for parallel. L is parallel to BC. L line and BC line both are parallel to each other. They have given in question, we have to find out X, Y, Z, three angles in this triangle. How can we find out? Very simple. This is a straight line, they have given L. Then total angles, adjacent angles, 75, X and 45, these three are adjacent angles. In a straight line, sum of these angles is equal to 180 degrees. We know that straight. In a straight line, total angle is equal to 180 degrees. So these three forms 180 degrees angle. 75 plus 45, 120. X plus 120 is equal to 180. Then X is equal to 180. If you transpose this plus 120, it becomes minus 120. 180 minus 120 is 60 degrees. Yes, we got X is equal to 60 degrees. Here, if you take L line and BC line, these two are lines. Then this AB is a transversal. Just this is a transversal in this. Just leave it for some time. The nodule side for some time. Okay, I'll rub it. If you rub this, now just check once, these two, L line and BC, two are parallel lines, then AB is a transversal. So when this is a transversal, check here, this is interior angle and this also interior angle. So alternate interior angles opposite side of the transversal. So, opposite side of the transversal interior angles are called as alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal. So, 75 is equal to Y. Therefore, Y is 75 degrees. Yes, confirmed. Next, here we have this line. Here, actually, we have this line. Now, just leave this line. Just forget about this line. Now, this L and BC both are straight lines. Now AC is a transversal. AC is a transversal. Now check here. This is Z interior angle and this is 45 interior angle. And opposite side of the transversal. So these two are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal. Therefore Z is equal to 45 degrees. Confirm X equal to 60, Y equal to 75 and Z equal to 45. Very simple. Here, this is the figure. From this, we have to find out angle A, B, C, D. Four angles we have to find out. Just check here if they have given any arrow mark like this. These two arrow marks. No need to give parallel lines. If they have given like this arrow marks, at the same side, we can say these two are parallel lines. This is symbol for parallel lines in our geometry. Okay. So, here you can observe, this is a line and this is a line. If I prolong these two. Observe here. These two are parallel lines. So, it is showing down and it is also showing, then these two are parallel lines. And this is a transversal. And angle A and angle 50, opposite side of the transversal and interior angles. Means alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal. Therefore, A is also 50 degrees. Next, if you go for B, same here. Okay, so come here first. These two angles. Wait. Now, prolong these two lines. This is a line and this is a line. You can observe these two are your arrow mark. Upside, these two are parallel lines. Then this become a transversal. When this become a transversal, these two are alternate interior angles. B equal to 50 degrees. Next, these two are alternate 50. These two are alternate interior angles 50 degrees. So A, B, C, D all are alternate interior angles. So all are equal 50 degrees. Observe this figure. This is, in this figure you can observe A, B and D, C. Are same arrow marks. So these two are parallel lines. AB parallel to DC. And here AD parallel to BC. AD parallel to BC. They have given in this figure. Now just check this, prolong this line and this line. These two lines are parallel lines. Then AD is a transversal. When this is a transversal, this is interior angle and this is interior angle. And two interior angles are the same side of the transversal. So, interior pair of interior angles same side of the transversal are supplementary. Means their sum is equal to 180 degrees. So, D plus 50 is equal to 180. Just transpose this plus 50 that side. It becomes minus 50. So 180 minus 50 is 130. D is 130 degrees. We got it here. Next, look here. If you go for C, this is a straight line. And this also a straight line. This is a transversal. So here, if you take this as a take here these two are parallel lines. These two. AD, BC are parallel lines. Then DC is a transversal. Then these two are interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Then these two sum is also equal to 180. When this is 130, this is 50. 130 plus 50, 180. And for this, these two lines parallel, this is a transversal. When this is a transversal, these two are same interior angles, same side of the transversal. Then this sum also should 180 supplementary. So when this is 50, this is 130. 130 plus 50, 180. So if we know one angle, we can find all angles by using this transversal. Here I give simple four questions. Please answer these questions. If you know the answer, please comment answers in comment box. Okay, thank you for watching. If you didn't subscribe my channel, subscribe my channel. And if you have any doubts in this, please give in comment box. Okay, thank you.